Good morning, everybody. Nick from Meat Smoke Fire here on a warm t-shirt, first time this year, but windy day. We are going to persevere with the little fluffy microphone that we've got by the phone, but apologies if it gets quite windy. It was lovely and calm until about an hour ago, and then it went nuts. So anyway, hope you all had a wonderful Easter. We had our friends over from Germany, so we spent the whole weekend cooking. So we did a lovely leg of lamb in the Charlie, and a picanha, and a pizza night, and all sorts. It was lovely. Anyway, today we thought we'd go Indian. We're going to do a recipe that you might see on Delavita's, the pizza people's website, because we did it with them. We did some filming with them a few weeks ago, and so we're just taking that recipe and doing it on the egg, because we've already written it up, and it's cracking. So three recipes. One is going to be a some sweet potato that I've already got on here. So these are just starting to roast. We need to get them going a bit. So they're roasting down. They and some spices are going to be our topping for our paratha, and we're going to make a spicy mint paratha. So we've got to do that. And then we're going to do a paneer 65. So we did a chicken 65 a while back. We're going to do a paneer 65. Am I supposed to melt butter, sir? There you go. I'll use a bit of oil. Halfway through, I said, about a second ago, I said, what am I supposed to do at this stage? And I've forgotten all about it. Anyway, right. Sorry, it has been...
It's going to be a car crash. Yes. Just saying. Just so. Morning. Welcome to the car crash.
Andrea on camera.
Yes.
Yeah, dressed in outdoorsy, well, almost summery. Yeah. You do look summery.
Thanks.
Awesome.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Oh, I'm off you then. God, missed you. Then we've got Helena on the iPad typing your answering your questions. And Mama is back, feeling
good
better.
Good morning.
On the red wine. Yeah. So things must be good. Yeah, so far this morning I've spilt my Coke twice. I've smashed a bowl. Anything else?
Can't get your words out.
Can't get my words out. It's going to be one of those days. Yes, I was drinking last night. With my brother's on. Anyway, right. I have made some of the stuff already because it just takes too long. So we've already got the sweet potato roasting. So it's up about 200 degrees. Hopefully that'll soften up. We'll put the spices over the top of it in a bit, and then those are going to go onto our paratha. So we are going to make our paratha. So we have, and this is a spicy mint paratha. So I have already made the dough. This is our dough, and it's got lots of fresh mint just through it. So it is literally just flour, mint, bit of water, dead easy. Recipe is already on the website, really easy. That is going to make
that mint already.
Yeah, it's absolutely Ooh. Delicious. So we're going to make five of them. So I'm going to do the next stage, which is to put the spices in them, and then we've got to put them. We're supposed to put it to one side for an hour, but we're not going to get a chance to do that. So I'm going to get a bit of flour. Now this is likely to blow everywhere. I mean, it's absolutely.
It's carnage. Yeah, it is. Go everywhere.
Yeah, we'll get that on there. We'll get our dough on there. It's all going to go wrong today. So this is going to make five. So probably the easiest way, just make it into a sausage shape and then go a little bit off center. And if they're not all exactly the same size, it doesn't really matter. So we've got five of those. So then what you need to do is roll them out. I'll probably only make two or three of them. Well, no, I'll do them all. Get them out, get them there, squash them down, and then roll them out. I bought one of these like weird oval, that's the right shape?
Indian rolling pin.
It's wicked. I don't know where it's from, Amazon probably. But it makes rolling these things out really easy. So I'll probably make two or three, so just so you can see, and then we'll make the others afterwards. Because we're all going out to dinner tonight. Get in. Well, we are. I don't know who I'm allowed to say anything to. Right, so I'll do two, and then we will cook those. So get them nicely roundish. These oval things make them easier to get them round, I've found. He says, making an oblong one.
I was just going to say.
Yeah, thanks. Yeah.
I'm thinking it's long enough to hit you with.
Probably. Oh, look at this, domestic abuse from the sister-in-law. Yeah. Anyway. Right, so we've got two of those. I'm going to put, you could put butter on them or ghee. I'm just going to put a little oil on them. Nice and thin. So just a little bit of oil. I think the recipe is butter or ghee, but this will be fine. Spread it around just to get them wet so that the next bit sticks to them. And we're going to do our herbs and spices. Right. In here. Sorry, I've got everything covered in cling to down.
I'm not sure how long it's going to stay in there.
Yeah. We've got some dried mint. So if it wasn't minty enough already, we've got two teaspoons of dried mint. We've got some cumin. We've got some chili powder. So this is Kashmiri chili powder. So it's not too hot, but it is bright red. And we've got some cumin. That's not cumin. No. Sorry, that is not cumin. This is cumin. That is, what's in my little thing?
Chaat masala.
Sorry, I am having a moment today. So we're going to get all of those, just mix them up. You can use your fingers. And this is enough spice to go on five of them. So they will then sprinkle it liberally over these because they want them to get a bit spicy. God, what happened to me today? Mm-hmm. We had a class yesterday. It was fabulous. Really fabulous. First class of the year. Great people. Anyway, we'll come back to that. So then you're going to take these and just roll them really tightly. Okay? So just roll them up. Get them like that. And then roll them into a snail shape. Is that the right shape?
Yeah.
And you can take the bottom bit, just tuck it underneath like that. And they're done. So we'll do the other one. Should have brought a plate for them, so I'll put them back in the bowl. That's fine. And the point of this is they're going to be layered then. If you get paratha from the, you can buy them frozen in Sainsbury's, just plain ones. And they're lovely. But you get them like this. They're going to have layers because we're going to roll them and squash them down again. So I'm just going to put those to one side. I put the bit of cling back in my pocket, so we're all right there. And I can put it back in the fridge. It doesn't even have to go in the fridge. It can just sit out. But I'm going to put it in the fridge just to keep it out of the wind. There we go. So these ones, we might do in a minute or two. I will put them in this bowl. Helena, could you, in fact, take those inside?
Yes.
And put some cling over so they don't dry out?
Yep.
That'd be brilliant. Because we'll use those. And then we've got this spice mix. Kept that bit too. Yeah, I will do a recap in 1 second. She's shouting at me from miles away, so you probably didn't hear that, especially in the wind. But we'll try and keep all of this spice mix in the bowl today. And it is, was howling, it stopped a bit now. Right, so the three things we're cooking a spicy mint paratha. So I've already done the paratha, put mint in it, made it into a dough. We've then rolled that out into really thin bits, put some oil on it or ghee. We've got a spice mix, which is we've just sprinkled over the top, and then we've rolled them up into snail shapes, and then we'll flatten them and roll them out a bit later and cook them. So that is our first dish. To go on top of that, we are cooking some sweet potato, so roasting some sweet potato. And so we're going to add some of our aloo chaat to that. It's aloo chaat, isn't it?
Yes. No,
chaat masala. Chaat masala. Why do I want to say aloo chaat today? I'm having moments. Anyway, chaat masala. If you haven't got chaat masala or can't get it, it is basically equal portions of coriander powder, cumin powder, and mango powder. So it's like a sweet, bitter.
It's lovely.
It's lovely. So we're going to put a couple of teaspoons of that over our.
Oh, hello.
Hello. Did I get you, Andrea?
Yeah.
Straight in the mouth. So you get some of that. Oh God, it's going to be. And we just give that a shush around.
Blinded in one eye now.
Yeah. But if you can't get it, make it with just those three things, equal quantities, Mango powder is also called
amchur.
But these are just going to roast off, so we'll get those going.
And crunchy Eleanor's here.
Yeah. I did know that, I was just testing it. Oh, it's one of those weeks. Class yesterday was brilliant. We had six people, so we sold out, which you as usual. We had three guys come up from London, and it turned out one of them has already been on the class, and I didn't recognise him, which is terrible.
That's nothing unusual.
I'm rubbish with faces and names and words and cooking and dropping things and all that. Yeah, met you before, oh, yeah. Once or twice. But it turns out he works with my brother, which was quite funny and should have been at work. Anyway. We also had Andy, who might be on, I don't know. And the pilot, Graham, and Sylvia, who works, has a garden business up the road. So yeah, it's good fun, good day.
And in fact, Phil is on this morning.
Phil and his grill.
Yeah.
Who was on the original class with Ross,
yeah.
Who I totally forgot, so, which is terrible. Anyway, just been one of those weeks. Right, that's going on. Those are resting. We are going to use in a bit, and we've done it before, a little tower pan. This is, you could use a skillet, but we're going to use this little Indian tower pan. I'm going to put it on the Minimax, and that's what we're going to cook our burrata on. So that's why I've got the Minimax here. Didn't bother with stand, I just put it on the bench. On this egg. And we're going to crack on with this now, and this is going to be, if we get a gust at just the wrong time, we're in all sorts of trouble here. So we are going to make, we're going to make a batter for some paneer. I just need to get a fork.
Super.
But it's got a lot of dry ingredients.
Lovely.
Which could shoot across the garden. So maybe we'll put in, what I'm going to do, put some lemon in here and hopefully they might stick to it. So just over a teaspoon of lemon. Try not to get all the seeds in like I've just done. Right, we'll get those out.
Yeah, lob them my way, don't worry.
Yeah. Right, lemon juice. About 4 tablespoons or 60 millilitres of water. So we'll pop that in there. This is going to backfire, I know.
Here we go.
Here we go.
Brace yourselves.
We have a tablespoon of plain flour and a tablespoon of ground rice flour.
Put it in quick.
Yeah, they're in. Let's get it whisked. I think we've got those. Okay, this is not the way to make batter, doing it the wrong way, but we're going to do it. We have also got in here a tablespoon, it's a bit over in fact, of corn flour, and we have some more Kashmiri chilli, a teaspoon of Kashmiri chilli, so they're going in. So the corn flour will thicken it all up. This is going to go on the outside of our chilli. I think we're getting away with it. And then into it, we've also got, God, it is windy. We've got 4 curry leaves that I've chopped up quite finely. Let's get those in there. That's the last bit that could blow away. And then we've got some ginger and garlic paste, about a teaspoon, and about half a teaspoon of salt. So those are all going to go into our batter just to make this a little bit spicy. Cool. Got away with it.
Panic over.
Yeah. Now you could marinade all of this stuff. You could put your paneer in and let it marinate for a little bit, but we're just going to go for it. I'll pop my pan into my egg. So this egg's sitting around 200. Just going to use a little cast iron skillet. Pop it in there, just let that warm up. And we are going to put, I've just got 220 grams of paneer that I've put into reasonable size cubes. And we're going to pop those in there and get them covered in that almost, it's almost a batter. Just to give them a bit of flavour. Now you could make it thicker. I probably put too much water in it, but we are where we are. So, in fact, can you grab me a little bit more corn flour? I'll just thicken it up a tiny bit so it sticks a little bit more. Yeah, went a bit heavy on the lemon and it's not as thick as it should be. So what you could do with this is you can either stick it in an air fryer, you can stick it in here in a cast iron pan, brilliant, or you could deep fat fry it as well. So So you could put it in a wok with some deep fat, some fat in it. Since the cast iron skillets are now all back in stock,
woohoo,
we're going to use a skillet. We just have a spoon. Thank you. So I'm going to chuck a little bit more corn flour in there. Get it. That'll just thicken it up a tiny bit. There we go. That's better. It's all sticking now. And what we're going to do, just put a bit of oil in our pan and then pop these in. And they're going to brown off. They're going to loosen up a bit. But paneer doesn't melt. You know, if you use normal cheese, it would just go all gooey. This is going to crisp up on the outside. So I'm just going to get some oil.
Did you manage to get that paneer from
Sainsbury's? Yeah. Yeah, Helena said, did we manage to get the paneer from Sainsbury's? Yes, it was from Sainsbury's. So I'm going to put a couple of tablespoons of oil in there. And then we'll let it warm up a little bit more. So we'll go over and see who's on.
Okay.
After you, Andrew.
Thank you.
So who have we got on, Helena?
Oh, so...
it's getting a bit hot.
We have got... I'm just going to go back to the top. Ben Bagley.
Morning, Ben.
We have got Vicky Mumford.
Morning, Vicky.
Beck Let's Eat Cake Morris.
Oh.
Andrew Stoneman, Mark, who was on Andrew's course a couple of weeks ago.
Oh, okay.
As in the gin man.
Yeah.
Sam Towler.
Morning, Sam.
G. Griffiths, Robert Tetlow, Andy Lorimer, who's watching with Elsie.
How did your gig go last night, Andy? Andrew was doing a. Andrew's got the other cookery school that we went to the other day. He was in Bedford Way with the FIA trailer doing a stag do, catering a stag do. So how did that go?
Stuart Duncan, Gordo Sales.
Gordo Sales?
Yeah, filling his grill, Karen
True. Gordo Sales is our man from the wine shop.
Oh, I don't know.
Yeah, could be.
John Pritchard, who's doing Indian himself tonight. Barbecue Slayer. Malloy's from Ellsworth. Karen
morning, Malloy's. Morning, Remy. Morning, Paul.
Eden. Another Mark. Sean. Simon Higgins.
Morning, Simon.
Phil.
Simon was on a class a few
Jackson,
years ago.
Mike Jackson. PJ Johnston. Nikki Cash. Home Pizza Oven. The T-shirt Company. Smoking Kelt. Jay Paternoster. Smoking Kelt Jeanette.
Brilliant. Any questions, any comments, or shall I get back to it?
Get back to it.
I'll get back to it.
I've asked what people are cooking, but I haven't got...
Right. Cool. What I'm going to do, I'm going to put this in to warm up. Now, it sticks outside, so I'm going to leave it open. That's not normally how we'd use an egg, but we're going to give it a go. What the hell?
See what happens.
Yeah.
And Ross has just joined.
Morning, Ross. How was your night in the pub last night? Was it a bit messy? These three guys booked and stayed in, two and a half. One was supposed to be going home. We don't know if he actually made it home, but okay. The three boys booked to stay in the Red Line in the village, which is great once you've done one of our classes. So yeah, maybe they did. Oh, now our neighbours are drilling or something, planing. Right, pan is warmed up. We are gonna take our paneer. Get it in there. I'm going to fry these. So it's going to take a little while. They'll go brown. Get the edges nice and brown. You could have marinated them a bit longer. Don't want to put too much of the juicy stuff in there, but what we do want to do is get this cheese just browned off on the edges. So you could deep fry it, as I said, or you can just go for it like that. Okay, we'll go back over there because we've got a question. Come on, Andrew. Keep up.
Get a grip, man. Rude.
What's the question, Ella?
So, PJ Johnson asked, what are your thoughts on charcoal currently?
Oh, has he spotted the bag?
I don't know.
We're currently trying out some Glow Baltic. Birch charcoal, he's spot on saying asked, you probably saw this in the back. If you look into it, the pieces are very decent. I don't know if you can see that, they're big. I had a pallet of big green egg stuff that wasn't the best, so I thought I'd try something else. So at the moment we're using that. We've tried the big K, which I didn't, it was okay. But I'm liking that.
House of charcoal,
yes. If you want, yes, good point, thank you, Helena. If you want British charcoal, we can't buy it in pallet loads from them, but you can buy individual bags from them, or several bags from them. House of Charcoal have just started doing British charcoal. So they'll have Whittlam Flame, they'll have Caradoc, they'll have several others. Stag from, which is actually Cambridgeshire now, he's moved. So yeah, they've taken all the British charcoal manufacturers, bringing them all into one place, and you can buy it from there. So look up House of Charcoal. I helped them out at Meatopia last year, because they'll be involved with all the charcoal for Meatopia. Whittlam Flame and James from House of Charcoal. So yeah. Yeah, any other questions?
No, the boys finished at 2 a.m.
Oh, well played, but 2 a.m. they got a lock in or something. Well played. That's a big night in our village. This is looking lovely. Right.
Got the car sorted, which is good.
Oh yeah, they had a puncture on the way down, but luckily had run flat, no. So they got here and they were on time. As usual, the person who is always last is the person who lives closest. So it was quite a funny day, because Andy, who arrived 45 minutes early and doesn't live that far away, got flagged down on the way because he was driving a Land Rover, because somebody had gone into a ditch, and he was asked if he could tow him out the ditch. He said, I haven't got time, and then turned up 45 minutes early. Anyway, right, I'm going to do these paratha. So obviously that's an hour they've been in there. We're rushing them a little bit.
Oh.
Yeah, thank you, Andrea.
You are welcome.
So again, a little bit of flour on our surface. We're going to take one of these. We're going to flatten them out, so they're nice and round. We're going to get a rolling pin, a little bit of flour on the top, and then we're going to roll it. And what we've got then is this spiral going on. You want to get these quite thin. We made these, a few weeks ago, didn't we? Mint, they were just standard ones, and these with all that spicy stuff in them are delish. Now you want to get them reasonably thin, so we're talking a couple of millimeters. They should be about 20 centimeters across when they're done. And then what we're going to do, and I don't know if you saw it last time, we're going to put them onto that tower pan, and then we hold down the edges with a wooden spoon, and that encourages them to puff up. They're delish. Last roll on that one. We'll take that one out of the way. It's ready. There we go. Get this one going. So do try this. These are all that. Can you smell that, Andy? You know, it's like a lemony, minty, and the spiciness that goes through them. With the chat masala in them. Have I got that right, chat masala? Yeah, cool, thank God for that. It's one of those days. Yes, there is. There is. There is, thank God for that. There is. She was telling me there's no chat masala. I'm like, well, there is in these ones. There definitely is in these, because I put it in this one. There's about two teaspoons, I think. And I'm right.
Jeez.
Yeah. Right. Lovely.
We'll sign off now. We're going
high. Yeah, should we leave it? Now, you don't want too much flour on them. So just rub your hand over them, get them excess flour out. Some people pick them up and slap them a bit. Lovely. Right. Same with that one. That one's actually better. Look at those. And they're how close to being exactly the same size as those.
Get you.
Right. Let's have a little look at our pan over here, which should be nice and hot. Yeah, you can see it smoking, so we're going to go straight on with it. I'm going to grab a wooden spoon. first one of these.
Let's do it.
Straight onto our pan. And then they take a little while. Second, but you just hold down the edges of them and that encourages them to puff up.
We hope.
Eventually, no, you've got to flip them. If they don't puff up, it's because I rushed the whole thing. I mean, they should have been in the fridge for an hour. Not 20, 22 seconds or whatever it was. It's starting to puff, can you see? Just starting. We'll tip them up, flip them over again. So this egg is set up to be roughly, should be roughly 180. Look at those. Just puffing in front of my spoon, but it isn't puffing as much as the ones we did the other day, but that is because we've rushed them. Still going to be stunning. Oh, and they're smelling amazing.
Mm-hmm.
Flip it one more time. They'll be light, they'll shred. I'm going to take that one off and put it over there and I'll go and get another one.
Don't drop it.
Haven't dropped it. Can't guarantee it won't blow away. Today, everything's... Yeah, these little tower pans are great. And they're like, I think I paid $8.99 or something at the Indian shop. Smell of these. It's just starting to puff, just. They puffed up more the last time we did them, but oh no, this one's fluffy in the middle. Flip it again. You don't want to burn them, but you do want to get those marks on them. There you go.
Yes, yeah. Success.
This one's definitely puffing up.
Ooh, look at that bad boy.
That's weird that one's gone so big. And there we go. So I'm going to take that one off. I'll flip him one more. Did I get you?
Yeah.
And these are going to be two gorgeous flatbreads.
Oh.
Yeah, I'm taking that off. Right, nice. We'll take that off. I'll lose this over here. That'll be fine. I'm going to shut the mini-max. We'll take this out.
Ooh, got up too quick then.
Oop, so we've got our two flatbreads. I'm just putting the lid of the flour on there, which probably means the flour will now go
yeah,
everywhere.
Yeah, that's now going to go over.
Right, let's have a look at our paneer. So these are starting to fry off, starting to go golden. Oh. Lost the bit of topping off that one, but that's fine. Oops.
I love that they do kind of caramelise
yeah.
there.
Well, that's the batter on the outside, yeah. Just sticking to them. They're sticking a little bit, that's fine. We'll chop them up a bit. So just shallow frying them. And then with these, so we can do it at the same time, we are going to make a sauce to go with them, the 65 element of it. So I'm going to use another little pan, or the little sauce pot from Big Green Egg, put a little bit of oil in there, and we're going to let that warm up. And then to that, we're going to add, I've got in here curry leaves, two chilies, a whole load of ginger and garlic paste, and then we put in the other bits of the sauce, which are a tablespoon of chili sauce, a tablespoon of ketchup, and a tablespoon of yogurt. So we mix those, and then we'll mix them at the end so it doesn't split, and then that goes all over these. They're going to be awesome. So let's go back to our
potatoes.
Sweet potatoes. which are caramelising beautifully.
Lush.
I'm going to go and get a fork and see how far off they are, and I will show you what we've done to go with them. Oop, nearly lost that. Oh yeah, that's soft. They're soft. They're done. You want a little bit of bite in them. Perfect. So they probably took what? They went on just beforehand. So they've taken 30 minutes, yeah. pretty much on the nose, 30 minutes. I'm going to take them off. I haven't got a rack though.
Oh,
hang on, I'll borrow one from the cupboard. Put it on my board. There we go. And we'll grab this. Left my gloves over there. Oh dear. Right. So let's take our, and we'll start pulling together our first dish. That second dish is going to take a little bit longer. So we'll get one of these out to my, do you want to grab a plate and I'll do two and then we can get one for Mama to try? So I will do the first one.
Oh yeah, after Mama.
Well, you know.
She missed last week.
She's yeah,
got
she
some
did.
Making up to do.
So, we're going to take some of these sweet potatoes and they can go all over our breads. Vegetarian, this.
Nice.
Right, I'll do another one in a minute when I've got a plate. Do you want to just pop one down there? There we go. So, we'll do the same for this one. And I'll show you what else we've made to go with them. There we go. Right, to go with it, we have, and this is delicious. This is an apple chutney. So it's got a green apple, so, you know, Golden Delicious or anything like that. It's got chili in it. It's got some spices in it. The recipe is on there. You just chuck it in the blender, some coriander in it. And it's appley, but it's spicy. It's amazing. So we'll get one done for Mama so she can taste it. It is a bit fiery. So I may as well do both at the same time, didn't I? We'll take a photo of this one at the end. Right, we've also done, and this is really strange, but lovely. This has got raisins and banana ketchup. Now, banana ketchup is a big Korean thing, or Filipino thing, sorry. You can get it in Asian supermarkets. My butcher sells banana ketchup, would you believe? It doesn't taste of bananas. It's like a ketchup, but it's just lovely. So banana ketchup, and then it's got a lot of tamarind in it, so it's got that sourness to it. So we're gonna put some of that on. It's delish.
I don't trust you, you just...
I'm not going to throw it over.
Yeah, you say that.
Whoop.
What, you see? Yeah. My face.
It was about 7 or 8 years ago, I covered you in flour.
Yeah, that
in the
came
kitchen.
Up.
It came up on my Facebook feed.
Yeah. We no need to share it anymore in this world, thanks.
We've also made a red onion pickle. So this is two tiny little red onions chopped up, a teaspoon of salt, teaspoon of sugar, and the juice of a lemon.
Half a lemon.
We all love this. I'm going to do it with my fingers. So we'll get that over the top. Bit of red onion pickle. I need to keep a bit back.
Yeah.
Because we're going to have some. And then the last bit to go on the top to add a little bit of crunch. I'll put some coriander on there. But it's some sev, which is like an Indian noodly. It's a snack. It's chickpea flour, just like in almost in spaghetti. So we'll put some of that over the top and that'll give it a lovely little bit of crunch. So we've got the paratas, we've got that. I'm just
awesome.
Gonna take this out of the way for a second, pop it on a Charlie. I'm gonna get a little bit of coriander and we'll get Mama trying this. So let's just do it, rip it up with our fingers.
Bit of green.
We've got a bit of red from the tomato, well, from the banana ketchup.
Do,
what's that?
Uh oh.
Apparently, I've forgotten something. Right.
Yes, I reckon finish it off nicely. The pomegranate.
Oh, I could put some pomegranate on it. Hang on then. I have a pomegranate here. Let's chop. Morning, Leto.
Morning.
Oh, morning, Mike. Wow. Right, I need a bigger bowl. Where's the big bowl?
I don't think you brought one out, have you?
I did put a spoon in it.
Here.
No, I've got a wooden spoon in a bowl, which I've obviously left in the kitchen. You've seen me take the pomegranates out of seeds out of a pomegranate. But essentially, I'll wait until we've got the bowl. You put your hand like that, put it, and then you just whack it, and all the seeds will just drop out. I had...
I think you've used...
I had a bowl, anyway. Well, doesn't matter.
I'll just Thank give you me another one to wash up.
Yeah. So just whack it, and the seeds will start to fall out. You'll get way more out of it than you get out of a packet of pomegranate from the supermarket. Get it all. You see that all the seeds just fall out. So we'll take a tiny bit of pith out of there, and we've got some lovely pomegranate seeds that we can then sprinkle over it as well.
Oh, you're right, Eleanor.
So I'm going to put some on this one.
Done.
Look at that. That is a dinner winner.
That is.
Right.
I'll have that a little bit.
So why don't you go and film Mama eating a bit?
Go on then, Mama.
No, how am I supposed to eat that?
With knife and fork.
I'll get you one.
Let's go there.
I'll get you a knife and fork. Well, Helen can have some as well while she's there. And then I will go and finish this other dish. Right, it's one. There you go. So, while they're eating that, and then we'll get a report, we're just going to split these up. I'm just going to get an eye. Oh. These chunks, they're just fused together. That batter has worked. Ooh, we've lost a bit there. Oh, well. They're all looking good. Look at those, they're fine. So into our little pot to make this sauce, we're going to fry a tiny bit of, I will grab a spoon. We've got some curry leaves, 8 or 10 curry leaves.
Oh, what is in there?
That's just oil. Just oil in there. Can you see those frying up? Mm-hmm. Bubbling up. We're going to put in our ginger and garlic paste and our halved chilies. So this is going to have some bite.
I did see a comment. Someone asked about your chili, your garlic and ginger paste. Do you make it yourself or do you get it out
now,
of the jar?
Now, we normally make it ourselves. However, the other day I was at the Asian supermarket down the road, I found an enormous jar for $2.99. So this is jar stuff. So far, it's been lovely. So go for it. Yeah, this is jar stuff. So we're gonna let that cook off. You just wanna get rid of that acrid, if that's the right word, taste of the garlic and the ginger. So just soften them, mellow them up. And then we're going to add to that our yogurt, our chili sauce, so it's sriracha I've used, and our tomato ketchup. And then we'll put that in the pan with the others, whisk them all up and serve.
Boom, job's a good one.
Yeah, so stir that around. Bubbling nicely. I'm just going to double dip. A little bit more. Although sweet, sweetening up now. I'll use a different spoon. Oh, hello, my coriander's flying around the garden. Oh, should we go over there? Let's leave that. Let's go and see what Mama thinks. What do we think?
It's absolutely delicious.
Mm-hmm. Good.
Yeah, very good.
Don't eat too much. Eat later.
Excellent.
Right, let's finish this one and we're done.
Okay.
Right. So this is bubbling away nicely. I'm happy with that. Fry it down and then we're going to add in these sauces. So I'm going to mix them together. Get it in there and stir. What we don't want to do is overcook the yogurt. If you want it really red, you could add some food colouring. Doesn't need it. Lovely. And then with a glove, take your sauce, we'll move this pan forward. We're going to get it into our pan. You're going to get a wooden spoon, coat it all up, and then serve it. Yeah, hang on a sec, Andrea. Get it into our onto our little serving pan. So it's going to have a bit of zing, it's going to have some lovely colour to it. Okay, I'm just going to get rid of that pan. We're going to serve it with my lime, which was there. So I'm just going to cut this lime. So wedge it. We'll put some wedges on there. Little bit of coriander. You could put some red chilli on if you wanted. And we're going to put some of our red onion. There we go. So, two vegetarian...
jeans.
I knew you were going to do that.
Two vegetarian dishes, but three really. Mint, spicy mint burrata, topped with our... roasted sweet potatoes, some onions. We've got a couple of chutneys on there. So we've got a mint, we've got an apple chutney, and we've got a banana and raisin chutney. And then we've got our paneer 65. So soft chicken, I almost said chicken.
You did.
Soft cheese with a 65 sauce, spicy 65 sauce. So we'll take it over. That was, felt pretty speedy. I'll just clear some of these out. Any questions, comments out of that?
No, everyone's loving the look at it. I've said that the sweet potato recipe is always already up.
Yep. The mint burrata's up.
I don't think it's published.
Yeah, I published it this morning.
Oh, okay, it is published. And then I need to write up the paneer 65.
It's linked. If you go in the Live Cooks, it's linked. It's not on the front page yet, but it will be shortly.
It's absolutely delicious.
You love that?
Absolutely.
I will love that.
Absolutely delicious.
Awesome.
And unintentionally vegetarian.
And vegetarian. Right, things we've got to tell you. Cast iron things are back in stock. Thank you, we installed a Big for Space on Wednesday. It looked fabulous. The new Big for Space gazebo is available. Rimas has put two in. If you buy one through me, I will come and install it with Rimas. So we will put the gazebos up. Lovely roof that goes over your head or your workstation. So we've got that. What else?
I wanted to say...
happy birthday to Jonas. So Carlos is...
Youngest,
so happy, what is he, 17, 18?
Yeah.
17,
happy
Jonas.
Tomorrow.
Happy birthday to Sol, who's our nephew, on Tuesday,
17.
I believe.
Yeah.
17 also. And congratulations, he came second in the Team Silver, in the European five-way championships. He was in Italy this month. I mean, for somebody who's doing his A-levels, he's only got one day at school in April.
Yeah.
He's doing gymnastics the rest. What else was there? Classes. If you don't book now, you're not going to get them.
Snooze, you lose.
Yeah, you snooze, you lose. There. Sorry about my neighbours doing all this planing, but anyway.
Next cook is the 27th of April.
Okay, next cook, 27th of April. We probably will be doing a special open house. Big Green Egg are doing an open day for all the resellers. They won't be doing it themselves. We will probably be doing that. It'll be the last weekend in May, right before my birthday. But watch out for news on that. So they will be sending us some beers, some food, and we'll be cooking it. And if you want to come here and just come and eat it, no charge, just turn up. But I'll announce it.
Yeah,
Helena's now looking. Helena's now looking rich. She might have booked a weekend away. You never know. Right.
I'm just going to imagine all of a sudden all these hundreds of people turn up. Like, oh my God.
We'll all be here. Well, some of us. Anything else?
We've got
new thermopens in stock. There's a brand new colour.
Yes, I like
it.
Midnight blue.
I've nicked it.
Oh, it's here. Love it. We've got them in stock as well. The new midnight blue thermopen
Nice.
The best thermopens there are, best probe thermometers there are.
Yes.
Awesome.
So we've got orange, red, green,
yeah,
and black.
Loads. That's it, I think. Yeah, that's all. Anyway,
next, next cook, 27th.
Yeah, you said that.
Okay.
Yeah,
yep. We're done.
We're going to go and eat. We've got all this to eat. So we're going to go eat. Have a lovely week, rest of your weekend. Grand Prix, I think, this weekend. I don't know. We'll see.
You'll be lucky.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. Right. Hopefully you've enjoyed that. We'll get the recipes up very shortly, and we're going to go and eat all of this now and have lunch. So have a great day. Cheers.